Hello everyone, welcome to the subject Computer Organization and Architecture. So today we are going to see an interesting case study about how memory restrictions in computer system can lead to serious side effects. So here we are going to see few cases that amounts to huge amount of money loss, okay. So here I think everybody will be knowing it, the odometer which runs in our vehicle, okay. So here the picture it shows the counter is of 5 numbers, is it not? 99999, is it not? When the odometer rolls over it, when it reaches the maximum value, what will happen? Again it will start from the very smallest value, so the counter will be cleared to all 5 zeros and it starts, is it not? So the one it doesn't affect it's not going to affect highly from the user side, since it's a mechanical analog that encounters an integer overflow. So overflow in the sense, so in a computer system or here something counter in the odometer, so there are a fixed digits are available, and when it reaches its maximum value it can't accommodate it, is it not? So only 5 digits are given here in this odometer, but the actual real time system is not limited to 5 digit numbers, is it not? So if the kilometer reaches more than 1 lakh and above, the odometer will be again rolled over to the initial value, okay. Somehow it's not going to affect in the real time, but a serious disaster will happen when the same thing happens in the computer calculations. So some of the cases we are going to see today in this case study, some famous cases involving integer overflow. So before that, we need to know an overflow or underflow. So for example, if we take a 4-bit register, so 4-bit register will So if a register is of 4 bit in size, so it will accommodate only 2 power 4 is equal to 16. It ranges to 16 numbers. What if the same register holds signed numbers? Signed numbers means both positive and negative. So it ranges from minus 8 to plus 7, is it not? So when we want to store a number beyond plus 7, like 8, 9, 10, those numbers cannot be accommodated in the register of size 4 bit, is it not? So that's said to be integer overflow. And there is one more thing called as an integer underflow. It means when we store the smallest value beyond the register capacity. For example, and the register of 4 bit size can accommodate a smallest value of minus 8. What happens, this further smallest value like minus 9, minus 10, etc. It can't accommodate those values. So in this situation, integer underflow occurs, okay. So take a real example, there is an in the year 1996, in the month of June, the European Space Agency launched the rocket named as Ariane 5, okay. And it uses the software from its predecessor like Ariane 4. So much of the software implementation of this Ariane 5 rocket was its predecessor Ariane 4, okay. So after the launch of this Ariane 5 rocket, so it self-destructed within 37 seconds due to the high reading of this new vehicle velocity. The software could not handle that high reading, because that involves the after this failure, the report says that the failure for this Ariane 5 is due to the data conversion from 64-bit floating point to 16-bit signed number. So 64-bit floating point is of two very big number that cannot be accommodated into 16-bit signed number, okay. That causes the operand error, and within the launch of 37 seconds, it amounts to some few billion loss to this European Space Agency. Okay, so we need to be in careful while handling the huge volume of data. The thing like the register size has to be programmed correctly so that we could avoid these huge losses. Okay, so this is one practical case that involves integer overflow, that is from 64 bit to 16 bit storage, a hardware software error that makes this huge disaster for this European Space Agency. So this is one case involving the integer overflow. And of course this one, Gangnam Style, everyone will be familiar in, and of course everyone watch this video in YouTube. So initially YouTube uses the 34-bit memory system for counting as a counter. So here I think you could see the number of viewers, it crosses more than 3 billion, is it not? So that 3 billion values cannot be accommodated in a 32-bit number system. And here is a picture, it shows the maximum storage value for the 32-bit integer. So if we store the signed number, signed means both positive and negative. So a signed number will store the integer value ranging from this to -2147483648 to plus this number. Okay, unsigned means both it means only the positive number, it ranges from 0 to this much of number. But the counter real time register will accommodate both signed and signed numbers. So using the 32 bit number system, it is limited to only the maximum value is this much. But look at here, the maximum view of this video. Okay, it goes beyond this maximum range. So it forces the YouTube site to switch its memory system to 64 bit to accommodate this much bigger size of viewers count. Okay, so this is one more example how the integer overflow was handled by this YouTube website. And one more case regarding millennium bug or Y2K problem. I think you might not hear about it because you are at that time as like a born babies. So when I was in my first year of this college, I get to know there was a serious problem going in the year 2000. I think the problem started in 1999 itself or the few years back by the computer. The one who involved in computer systems are deeply depressed that the system will be totally crashed when it reaches the year 2000, because the systems in those years in 1970s, around those years, were developed to hold the abbreviated form of the year. Instead of storing 4-bit number for the year, it uses the 2-digit numbers. So 1998 means it simply stores 98 instead of 1998. Okay, then when it reaches the year 2000 means it will be again rolled over to 1900, because for saving the memory space, the computer system uses only the 2 digits. So what happens when the year 2000 reaches means the last 2 digit only the computer system will use to store it. Okay, so there was a serious problem going on in that year, and this is one electronic sign display in the year of 3rd January 2000 in France. So the display, electronic display, is in the French language. So it displays the incorrect date as 3rd January 2000 as 3rd January 1900. So because of this issue, millennium bug or Y2K problem, because and these electronic devices is used to was designed that time to hold only the 2-digit last 2-digit number of the year. Then today the report says that over $3 billion were spent for upgrading the computer system to resolve these issues. Okay, so I think nowadays you will be knowing that all your computer systems are upgraded to use the year as only a 4-digit number. So you could check it out rightly in your computer systems. It will never use the abbreviated form of the year as a last 2-digit. Okay, so the problem was resolved by spending huge amount of money. So it's all because of this overflow. Okay, and lot more cases are there. So since I have discussed here only the 3 cases, and there are ways to handle the overflow if we program in if we program the things in very careful and elegant very careful manner, and assigning the appropriate data types and analyzing the operand values by rigorous testing. And some other methods are available by using tools like a statistical analysis tool, formal verification, and lot more methods are there to overcome this overflow problem. The only thing is that before launching or before implementing, we need to go undergo the rigorous test to see whether an overflow will occur when we handle the huge volume of data. So it's easily avoidable, but it needs an enormous effort to rectify the this situation overflow, whether the overflow occurs when we go for handling the huge volume of numbers. There are serious steps involved that needs to be done in order without before launching anything which handles the sensitive applications, like so rocket launching and some electronic devices handling huge volume of data, etc. Okay, so only so with this you will be the topic here aims how the overflow integer overflow the integer overflow affects, or it brings enormous side effects to the final product. Okay, so I hope you all understood today's case study. So that's it. Thank you all.